I'm going to show a demo of the website which I created for the data visualization project. The URL for the website is over here. You can see this one. And then as you can see, the title is Social Network Analysis and Sentiment Analysis. The whole theoretical concept and how the algorithm works is in the later part of the video, and I'll be explaining it on a whiteboard. Right now I'll just give a basic demo of how to use this website and what all data can you get out of it. First, we need to enter a topic over here. Let's assume the topic is climate, and the count as default it's 300. You can see the histogram, it's quite sparse. If you want, you can take a good number of data, like around 600 tweets. It's a random number. If you want to have more data, it will take a lot of time to retrieve also. You have to wait for some time. And if you want, you can see the tweets by scrolling out to this area, and then you can see all these tweets are related to the climate section, and there are 600 in number. So then after the data is retrieved, you can choose many functionalities over here. One of them is the histogram node degree. What this means is, you see the number over here, it's the degree of the net nodes, and there is the frequency. I'll tell you how this is plotted using the next figure, which is a network diagram. Here you can see this network diagram. Basically, there's a term document matrix formed in the first phase, where you, on the column side you have the tweet number, and on the row side you have the terms, and it's just like an adjacency matrix, and with that we form a network diagram. And the connections over here mean this, that these two terms are in the same tweet, and yeah, that's how this form. And from this we form the net histogram node degree. In here the number 20 means the degree of the vertices both in and out, and the frequency means how many of them are in number. As you now understood this histogram node degree and network diagram, let's go to the community detection. There are three algorithms available: edge betweenness, label propagation, and fast and greedy. You can use any three of these algorithms, and you can see the respective output. So you can see here for the label propagation, you can see the communities over here. I have enabled the label names also so that you can see what these terms are. You can use different algorithms and these will result in different outputs. These are just three approaches to community detection. As I have taken many tweets, it's taking a lot of time to process. Yeah, and here you can see there are communities over here, and yeah. The next we would like to go to word cloud. As you might have seen the fancy word ordering structures, where you see the dominant terms in larger size and the minimal terms in a smaller size for a topic. As you have searched for the topic climate, you can see these terms, they are more closely related, and all the terms are kind of relevant to current date because these tweets are from the past 7 days, not an old data set. It's from the past 7 days. 7 days it's extracted. Then you can go to sentiment analysis, and how this sentiment analysis is happening, and on what basis are these counts showing up, I have explained in the later part of the video. Right now all we need to see is there are 10 emotions, and these are the counts of how many words are there in the whole tweets that portray this particular emotion. If you want to add any features or anything, there is a source code for this. You can have a look at it. Yeah, and that is the demo part. Now let's go to the theoretical part of the whole presentation. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Akshar, and I'm going to give our final project review for the course data visualization. So our project is basically, we developed a website which has all these features, and I'll show you a video tutorial on how to access it. But first I'll give you a theoretical introduction of what is happening and how it is happening. So first let me talk about the main part, which is retrieving the tweets. we implement hard-coded the retrieving part in the code, but basically what all you have to do is just enter the topic name and the count of tweets you want to retrieve, and you can even see the tweets if you don't trust us. There's a feature for that also. And next, after we retrieve the tweets, we form a network diagram, which we kept some basic constraints like the in and out degree should be less than 30 or something like that. You can change it whenever you want to. So let me explain you how a node diagram is formed. So as you can see, there are nodes and there are some directed edges. What these nodes mean are the dominated terms in the tweets, and you can see these connections. These connections mean that these both terms occur in the same tweet together, and this connection means that these both terms occur together. And if you can see, these three terms are also connected together if they have a cyclic edge. So this is basically how the network diagram works. And from here, you can say what can we infer by seeing it. And because the main purpose of data visualization is what we can infer from the data. Based on this network diagram, we will form what is called histogram of node TV. What it shows is you can see a bar chart something like this and some numbers over here. What these numbers mean is the degree of the nodes. For example, you see somewhere a degree of 10 and a frequency of, for example, 5. That means there are nodes with degree 10, and those kind of nodes are 5 in number. The more data you retrieve, the more left shifted the histogram will be. That basically means you have a good rich amount of data. So enough with the histogram and the network diagram. Let's go to what is called community detection. So as you formed the network diagram before, you might be wondering what terms are more closely related, or what terms are not closely related. How can you segregate the data? So we have three algorithms over here: edge betweenness, label propagation, and fast segregation. So implementing these three algorithms will give you three different results. But you can see what terms which you feel like more closely related are always grouped together in all of these three algorithms. They are just three different approaches, and you can instantly say if two terms are not in a cluster, say in the same cluster, they are not related. You can easily see that, and I have enabled that you can see the terms in the graph so that you can easily verify the results. And then you can go to the word cloud. So what you can basically say about word cloud is you might have seen many places like in the websites or blogs, fancy terms and many terms related to a topic are shown in a very fancy way, like circles or alphabets, and they look kind of pleasing to your eye. So that's what I also have created. These figures are generated based on the data you provide, like the topic which you set in the tweets before, and the count of data. The more number of tweets, the more diverse and the more complicated word cloud you get. So that's how word cloud works. And one more interesting aspect in this is the size of the term in the word cloud is based on the dominance of the term. It's not like random. The bigger term you see, the more dominant it is in the whole corpus. The corpus is a collection of tweets. And then when you go to sentiment analysis, this is the most mathematical and interesting part of our project, I can say. So I'll just explain it basically in a very, very basic mathematical terms. For example, we retrieve the tweets, right? For example, I retrieved 5 tweets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And it has some content. And I did some pre-processing steps before, like for example, removing URLs, removing hashtags, removing stop words in English language. I removed all those terms. After that, I get some words in every tweet, right? There are, for example, if there are 10 terms in the beginning, it will be out to some 5 or 6 terms. So we have these are the terms which convey some meaning in the whole tweet. So then each word, you can categorize each word as this. Each word has a binary 1 or 0 in 10 parameters. In the sentiment analysis, we use a function which rates each and every term in 10 parameters. You can see in the graph there are parameters like anger, jealousy, happiness, sadness, this kind of thing. For example, you can expect for a word happy to have 0 in anger, 0 in anxiety, but happy in 1 and anxious is 1. Like that, for every term you get some values. 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. For this term. 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 of 10 parameters. And then it will add up all those parameters for each tweet. And then it is showing you the sentiment analysis. For example, for the word anger, there are, for example, 600 count addition. It means that there are 600 terms in this corpus which portray the emotion anger. So you can also see for other emotions. You can verify this basically by collecting happy tweets. Like, for example, if you collect tweets regarding the term happy and you do sentiment analysis, you can see that the happiness parameter is very high and anger one is low. And for example, controversial topics like politics and all, you can see topics like disgust, jealous, those are more. And for example, if you see climate and all, they are quite balanced because you can see tweets related to climate change as quite happy and anger also sometimes. Yeah, this is how the sentiment analysis works. If you want the code, you can maybe reach out to me in some way. And then, yeah, this is the whole presentation. And I'm attaching the review file as well as the PPT with the mail in which you got this video. Thank you.